So Josh and I were just talking during the lunch break here, how to write a mission statement. Mission, vision, value statement, and is it important? How do you do it and why you should do it? So I've got Josh back here again. Josh is Canada's top rated CPA and North America's most sought after fractional CFO. Josh, welcome back to the show. For the viewers today, we're going to be talking about how to write a mission statement, but you were telling me it's not even about how to write a mission statement, but more so why to write a mission statement. Can you share what we have here? Because I've got some, you know, excerpts from your manuscript here of your book that's coming out.
Yeah.
And myth number 81, you stated, you said that corporations' problem, right, that the corporation's problem, the vision, the mission, and the values are unimportant. Most people, and come on, let's face it, like most entrepreneurs, myself as well, I thought it was a bunch of woo-woo stuff. You know,
yeah,
it's the stuff that we were taught in business school, yeah, to write in the business plans. What's your take on it?
I mean, I came out of business school with the exact same view of it, that these are fluffy skills that don't really matter.
Right.
Then you start really drilling down into what actually happens to employees. You know, more than 70% of employees are actively disengaged at the job that they're at.
Right. They're checking their Facebook, they're checking their emails, their personal stuff.
And yet one of the strongest reasons why someone stays in a job is because of workplace culture.
Right. Right?
If they don't understand why they're doing and what value it brings, you're going to have actively disengaged employees, right?
Right.
You want them to buy into the problem, vision, mission, and values. Because an entrepreneur, it's kind of clear in our head, but the problem, vision, mission, and values, this is a way to actually, get it in the hands of the people who are actually doing the work for you. So we have to understand what that is.
That's the difficult thing here, Josh. When I conduct team meetings with my employees, I feel it too, right? And I think the viewers who are watching this are business owners as well too. We as the entrepreneur, as the owner, are very passionate, but then how do we can't force the employee. I know they're here for compensation many times. We create an environment that attracts them. Maybe they want to be around A players and other team members, but you know, when I start talking during our monthly meetings or quarterly meetings to the team and I start talking about the mission, the vision, I can sometimes see my team members glazing over a bit, you know?
Yeah.
And they're just kind of like, oh yeah, there he goes again. Yeah. Desmond, the CEO, he's going to talk about it again.
Yeah.
You know, but how do we convey that to them? How do you teach that?
First of all, let's separate it because some people have different terminology on what, you know, a vision and mission statement is.
Yeah, what's
is,
the
right?
real world meaning of a
so
mission, vision?
The way I encourage people to think about it is, first of all, we have a problem, you know? People only buy things to solve problems.
Right.
So let's figure out what that problem that we're solving is first, right? The next thing I like to do is to have a vision. A vision is a long-term objective, something that I can count, but something that necessarily I can't do within a year.
Can you give an example? What does that mean?
For example, we want to have 1,000 simultaneous clients. 1,000 simultaneous fractional CFO clients. That's a
right.
very difficult thing to do, not something that I can count, that I can do in a year, but I can definitely count it.
Do right? I have to put a time or a date on it, like a deadline?
You don't have to put a deadline, but you need to be able to account it.
Got it. Okay, so count and problem. Well, solving a problem, we can count the vision. Okay,
the mission is now something that you do every single day, you know. This is your one test that you run every single decision by. If it's a difficult decision, you know, what would the mission statement tell me to do, right?
In fact, I heard mission and values are the things that your team members, they use as their kind of a checkboard, their check and balance.
Their guide.
Guide to make decisions on a day-to-day basis.
So you think about it, in our firm, the problem is that 96% of Canadian businesses go out of business within 10 years, okay?
Right.
The vision is we want to have 1,000 simultaneous clients. The mission, helping Canadian businesses beat the odds. You know, I used to have helping Canadian businesses beat the odds through planning, reporting, and analysis. And then I realized that if I can help them beat the odds, I really don't care if we have to help them walk their dog. We just need to do it for them, right? And then the values are the things that we have identified that are important to us and actually, you know, the traits that successful entrepreneurs tend to exhibit.
Right. Now, what about values? Because I know I've read a lot of different books, you know, even the EOS system by Gino Wickman, I think, and Scaling Up by Vern Harnesh. You know, there's a lot of entrepreneurs that talk about the values in the company, creating a company culture using the values. What's your take on that and how do we do that?
It's really important, right? And here's where we need to get away from the business school definitions of these things, okay? In business school, you know, they're really trying to help us write these very verbose, very politically correct statements that nobody actually memorizes within the company, okay?
Right.
Your you know, your vision and mission and even your values a lot of times, they should actually be polarizing in a small business. So some people will read that, both customers and employees, and the customers will read that and they won't want to buy from you.
Right.
Employees will read that and they won't want to work from you.
Correct.
That's okay, because as a small business owner, generally, if you can capture 1% of the local market in whatever niche that you're in, you're probably the richest person in your entire family. So you don't want to waste time with customers and employees who fit outside of that, right?
So it's actually a filter. It helps you to filter.
It's a filter, right? And it should be polarizing. We shouldn't worry about these politically correct ones that are trying to say we're everything to everybody. You know, if you're the local utility company, if you're TELUS trying to beat Bell,
yes.
You know, if you want to acquire 60% of the market share, you have to start thinking that way.
Correct.
Be everything to everyone. But if you're the average small business owner, it's counterproductive, right? Because you want to acquire first the customers and employees that most closely align with your core values.
Understood. And in fact, you know, if you, anyone's watched my YouTube videos on my YouTube channel, you'll know that I also have another mentor. His name is Dan Locke. He's a multimillionaire. And we actually did an exercise within the company, the organization, as we were growing and scaling it, to come up with the company values. Now, we did it as a team, Josh.
Yep.
Over there. And everyone, what we did was we just had a whiteboard one day during a corporate quarterly meeting, and we all started shouting out values.
Mm.
And each individual member contributed a couple of lines, and then we kind of compressed it down, you know, keep, kill, combine.
Yeah.
Right? Now, for your company, how have you guys come up with the values? And what would you recommend for a viewer watching this? How should a CEO, should I involve my members in creating the values, or is it something that comes purely from you, the owner?
I think it comes from the business owner.
Okay.
Business, I like to say, is a benevolent dictatorship. So,
the pirate ship, right?
You care what they think,
yes.
To get enough to get their input, but ultimately you got to make the decision, right?
Right.
And especially when it comes to small businesses, you know, we don't really have to worry about what the market research says. What color a logo should it be? Should it be blue or should it be
yellow?
You know, yellow, right?
Right.
It doesn't matter, because we're not trying to get that fraction of the market, right? So it needs to be what energizes you the most. So if you don't like people who are not on time, don't deal with people who are not on time, right? If you don't like people who, you know, refuse to have a conversation when they're upset and they just want to send, you know, emails back and forth, don't deal with those sort of people, right?
Right.
So you can, you know, the business exists to serve you,
right?
Right. And we need to make sure that we're actually creating that environment. We don't want to walk into the business that we own and suddenly realize, like, I hate it here.
Mm-hmm.
If you hate it here, it's your own fault, because you created that.
You created,
right?
a committee instead of you being
I don't want a committee, right? Let's find what you actually want to do, and then bring people on your team who just naturally align with that, right?
Got it.
We're not going to take a little bit from this person here and a little bit from that person there. It ends up with nobody happy.
Right, and most of those people won't be with you anyways. You've talked about it in one of your other videos.
Yeah.
By the way, in this series here, we've got a lot of other videos that are going to be very helpful for you as a business owner, as an entrepreneur, to grow and scale your business. So check out the I button up there, click that, and you'll get the whole playlist, or click in the description below and you will find the descriptions to the other videos, such as pricing, such as team, you know, team management capacity, all these other topics that we've covered already in the past. So Josh, from your book here, you know, what are some action items? You know, you even quoted Zig Ziglar here. You said, you do not build a business, you build people, and people build the business.
Yes.
Zig Ziglar. Talk a bit about that. Why did you select that quote for this chapter?
So as business owners, we forget sometimes that, you know, we forget that we're responsible to educate these people. And
right.
When they come into our business, we're thinking about our business all the time. You know, we're working in our business 60, 80
sales,
hours a
marketing,
week, right?
Yep.
A lot of people working for you, you know, they're in it, you know, 40 hours a week. Maybe they're a part-timer. Maybe they're only in it 8 hours per week, right? So, you know, in our heads, we've repeated it to ourselves so many times, we realize that no one else is in our heads. Our employees are not in our heads. We've said it 1,000 times to ourselves, but we haven't said it to the people who actually matter, the people who are actually working for us. So you will generally drastically underestimate how many times, you know, you have to communicate the problem, vision, mission, and values, and tie specific daily occurrences. You know, we had this interaction with a customer, we did this, but our mission statement said we should have done that.
Right,
instead,
and that's why,
right?
Things went.
And that's why it went wrong, right? And we have to over-communicate that over and over and over to our employees, because they're not privy to the conversations that are going on in our heads.
Yeah, actually, I've noticed that too. I've worked with so many fractional billionaires and millionaires, and the one time even Dan or even yourself many times, I noticed that many of the visionaries, you've got this conversation going on in your head and you think everyone knows what's going on. But what's a regular cadence? For someone watching this, what's a regular cadence of bringing up the vision, the problem, vision, mission, and the values? Is it done on a weekly basis, on a monthly basis? Is it done on a quarterly basis?
Every single day. You should have a group team huddle with your staff.
Yep.
And I'm thinking if you've got a really powerful mission statement, it should be visually identifiable within the business, right?
Print it up on the wall, put up on the office if you have an office.
You've walked through our Edmonton headquarters and on the top of every single whiteboard.
Beat the odds.
Helping businesses beat the odds. Yep. Every single time. What are we doing here today? We're doing that, right?
Got it.
Weird situation comes in. How do we handle it? What does our mission say we should do?
Yeah. Does it help beat the odds? If it doesn't, then they're not for us.
That's right.
It makes a lot of sense. If you found this video helpful and you want to find out more or get some more information from Josh, don't forget to comment below, hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notifications. You can get other videos as well too. If you post a great question, guess what? I will get Josh not only to answer it, we may even make and shoot other future videos to answer your specific question. So make sure you comment and write great questions for us. And with that, we'll see you in the next video.